Rose family's gigantic mansion from the Schitt's Creek pilot is indeed a real home, and it's selling for nearly $15 million. And all the listings and rentals as seen on TV are what's seriously popular today. Real estate insider Baruch Shemtov joins me now with more information on the latest listings. Baruch, tell us about the Schitt's Creek mansion.
Yeah, so you may remember, Alicia, in that first episode, the Rose family gets evicted from their gorgeous home. Well, it turns out that's not just a TV set, that's a real house. It's in Toronto, Canada, and it's called La Belle Maison. And boy, is it a belle maison. It's a three-story mansion, 24,000 square feet, 12 bedrooms, 16 bathrooms. It took 5 years to design, and boy, did that pay off. Check this out. It features unbelievable carved limestone and marble and frescoes. Super luxurious. It even has its own banquet hall so that you can host your own gala without ever leaving your home. Very glamorous.
I'm in awe. Let me pick my job off the floor. I could definitely find a nice dress to wear to a gala in that beautiful home. Baruch, what's next?
Well, this next home isn't quite as glamorous. This is the site of the infamous Lizzie Borden double axe murders. So those took place about 130 years ago. This home is in Fall River, Massachusetts. It was turned into a bed and breakfast where guests could stay in the actual room where the victims were found. And now, if you're ready to have some nightmares, this home could be yours for $2 million.
Baruch, I'm gonna say no thank you and a hard pass on that one. But I also heard the house from Signs of the Lambs is now a bed and breakfast. Scary, but what do you know about that?
Yeah, so this home was on the market for $300,000 and a mega fan bought it. In fact, he turned it into a movie-themed destination like no other. Those are his words because he turned it into a bed and breakfast. So now you can go visit it. You'll take a look. You'll see that the three-story structure is largely intact, just the way you saw it in the movie. And now you can go visit it. You can stay there. You can throw a wedding there. You can do filmings there. They're open to guided tours. And apparently they're about to put a pool on the two-acre property.
All right, Baruch, still a little scary to me, but the next bed and breakfast isn't for sale. But if you're a Bill Murray fan, you might want to check out your next vacation at this place. Tell us about the Cherry Tree Inn, Baruch.
Yeah, so if you remember Groundhog Day, take a look at the exterior of this bed and breakfast. This is the exterior of the lodge where Bill Murray's character Phil Connor stayed. Well, it's now called the Cherry Tree Inn. It's in Illinois, not Pennsylvania, where the 1993 film actually took place, but it's really cozy, it's very classic. You can live out your Groundhog Day fantasies and spend a nice weekend at this beautiful bed and breakfast.
Baruch, thank you so much for joining us. And that is what's seriously popular today.